I know there's a long queue outside. Many, many more people are coming. I pass on to Mr. Lord Villimoria to welcome you and say a few words.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Virendra. Virendra is the chair of the All Party India Group, which I'm proud to be a vice chair of. And I founded the Zoroastrian All-Party Parliamentary Group, and Virendra is vice chair there, and we work very, very closely together. I wasn't sure I could be here today, because there's a lot happening today, including it's my son's, older son's 21st birthday. So, but I did say to Bharata that if I can, I will come, and even if it's for a few minutes. I'm so happy I've been able to be here, because the main reason is I think that what is happening in this room here is so crucial and so important. And when I hear the stories that abound of what happens to women, to girls around the world, it shocks me, it saddens me, and I cannot believe it. And if somebody is willing to do what Bharata Patel Kamble has done, and supported by her husband, Dr. Kamble, I think what they've done is amazing. And to think that her journey to highlight this started exactly 1 year ago, almost tomorrow, 13th of September, she started her journey and drove herself. What car did you drive, by the way?
BMW X3, my family car.
BMW X3, she drove across the Arctic Circle through 32 countries, 12 Indian states, and was received in India in November by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Now this, and it all, and the other link that we have is the Bharatas from Navsari. And there were Parsi ladies involved as well. Where are the Parsis? Please can they stand up? Please get the Parsis who took part in this. You know, the women in the history of India, the history of the world, why there is all this, it baffles me. I mean, we are about to have a Zoroastrian all-party parliamentary group meeting just now, coming up. And we're going to be celebrating Madam Bikaji Kama, who was the first person to unfurl the Indian flag, who was a freedom fighter, who was here in the UK. And people don't know about this. And this happened a century ago. Do you know, it is shocking. I always show everyone I take around Parliament that there is a plaque there saying when the first woman took their seat in the House of Commons. Do you know, it is not even 100 years since that has happened. I find that shocking. There was a Queen, Victoria, who served for 63 years on the throne, but no woman had been sitting in Parliament over 100 years ago. I think that's just appalling. And to me, the most, in my whole life, if I can thank one person more than any other person, it's my mother. The most important person. And the second person I would thank alongside my mother, without whom I wouldn't be standing here, is my wife. So these are the rocks. My father became Commander-in-Chief of the Central Indian Army, commanding 350,000 troops. He was a brilliant soldier, he was a popular soldier, he was head of the Gurkhas in India. But everyone said, General Villimoria, you would not have got there without Mrs. Villimoria. And it's a fact. It is her support, behind the scenes a lot of the time. It is her support when he was army commander. She had her own office and she was in charge of the welfare of more people than he was in command of. Because she was in charge of 350,000 troops and their wives and their families. It was a full-time job that she undertook with pride, with dedication, and without much acknowledgement. So this is the tireless striving. If you go around the drive, whenever I drive through India, and I have breweries, we have it around the districts of India, in the middle of Bihar, who is working in the fields? It's the women who are working. And And then to hear the shocking stories that Bharat is going to tell you about, I just as a human being cannot understand how people can feel like that. One of my regrets in life is I didn't have a sister. I have one brother. Now I have two daughters, and I'm so happy. So, why has it taken this country so long that we've had a queen now, the most amazing lady, Queen Elizabeth II? The whole of this country loves her and respects her. Her dedication and hard work, which I have seen firsthand. I have seen her come here and do a state opening of parliament, then go on somewhere else for another engagement, and then go on somewhere else for another engagement. I've seen her do four engagements in one day. I've seen her come up to Birmingham, where I'm Chancellor of the University, where she opened the new Birmingham Railway Station, and then she came and opened the dental hospital and campus at the university, and had lunch and spent the whole afternoon, and then went back to London at the age of 90 with her 95-year-old husband. That is the dedication and service, and she's the longest reigning monarch this country has ever known. But she was only the monarch because there was no brother. How long has it taken for us to change the rules in this country now that the succession has changed, and now it doesn't matter whether it's a boy or a girl, it's the eldest who will become the next monarch. So that is how it should be. When will we learn as a world? So this country is still waking up, and in India, when I hear stories where near the brewery we've supported work with charities to build toilets at schools. Just sanitation. If I give you the statistics of the lack of sanitation in India, and how dangerous it is for a girl to actually just go to the bathroom. It's shocking. I mean, it saddens me. They're scared to go. Why should that be the case of a country that is now looked upon as an emerging global economic superpower? And the Prime Minister acknowledges this. The Prime Minister, it's not something that yes, India can have a Mars mission. Yes, India's got a space program. Yes, India's got phenomenally advanced industry, entrepreneurs, but we've still got these problems on the ground that need to be resolved. And that is why this problem of save girls, educate girls, has got to be at the forefront. Because India's GDP growth rate wouldn't be 7% today if the opportunities for the women were increased. The growth rate would be 14, 15% per year. It would double, literally, if we gave and improved the for women at every level. And what you're doing is saving lives. What you're doing is uplifting lives. What you're doing is priceless and precious, and we should all appreciate it. So thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Lord, for your kind and nice words. And we are very proud of you. We are very proud of your Indian origin as well. We would like to invite Bharudatta to kindly felicitate you.
Strongest supporter that you have been, and please continue to support us.
Yeah, I wish you all the best.